would like to make a call. Please hang up and try again.
If you haven't already seen the condensed trial of Chandler Halderson, you should check it out. There'll be a link at the end of the video. I'm Holly.
And I'm Max. And we're just going to have a look at the interrogation of Chandler that was presented as evidence in his 2022 trial. Chandler is 23 years old, living at home. There are a few other people left out of the condensed trial, just because their involvement didn't lead to any real evidence.
Chandler's brother Mitchell had his own life and moved out of home. He had an IT job and a relationship and had nothing to do with Chandler's actions at all. That's why I left him out of the condensed trial. The same goes for Chandler's girlfriend Catherine, or Kat, who is unfortunately another victim of Chandler's actions. She was very close to Bart and Krista, and they intimately shared each other's lives daily.
Kat would Snapchat Chandler, sometimes over 100 times a day. Her Snapchats were used as evidence of Chandler's location and led the police to finding portions of his parents' bodies.
Dan, Krista's co-worker, was also left out of the condensed trial for similar reasons.
So as far as everyone knows, Chandler is employed and also studying. He had worked as a police diver, obtained a solar certificate, and was currently about to graduate from Madison Area Technical College. He also had a job working at American Family Insurance and had a job offer from SpaceX in Florida. By all accounts, he seemed to be doing really well and progressing into adulthood in the same manner as his brother had already done. But he had a bunch of email correspondence from Gmail addresses he had created himself, which he pretended were from people working at the college and American families.
He used these emails to support his lies about attending college and being employed.
Yep, these were all lies. He really spent his time playing video games, watching movies and YouTube, instead of having any employment or going to college. Chandler's father, Bart, calls the Madison Area Technical College and discovers that his son has not and is not getting any certificates and owes the college about $2,000.
This interrogation takes place on the 8th of July 2021. Chandler is questioned about events that start from the 1st of July through to the 8th. During this interrogation, Chandler has already killed both his parents.
Yeah, they're already dead. And the police know. But Chandler doesn't know that the police know.
Yeah, go send that red shirt. Yeah.
What's in the cup? Just water.
Yeah, one water. Under.
Okay.
Here's an extra checker.
No, here's it.
What's going on? All right, so we're just going to talk to you a little bit more, okay? Let's write some stage here.
The other one.
Alright, just so you know, I'm gonna record stuff, okay? It just helps me remember everything and picks up everything that we talk about. Alright, so Brian Shunk, Detective Dane County Sheriff's Office, we spoke yesterday.
Yeah, Chandler Halderson.
Yep. What's your middle initial, Chandler?
M
is in Michael.
Michael.
And then your birth date?
3/15/1998.
Got it. And then your cell phone, I already have. We've been talking on that. So obviously we're here. We want to talk a little bit about your parents going missing, right, Krista and Bart? Before we get started, just because you're up here, okay, so I'm just going to read you your constitutional rights, okay? So it's a Dane County issued card that they give us, so I'll just read them to you right off the card, okay? You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to consult with a lawyer before questioning and to have a lawyer present with you during questioning. If you cannot afford to hire a lawyer, one will be appointed to represent you at public expense before or during any questioning, if you so wish. If you decide to answer questions now without a lawyer present, you have the right to stop the question and remain silent at any time you wish, and the right to ask for and have a lawyer at any time you wish, including during the questioning.
Okay.
Do you understand the rights I just read you?
I do.
Okay. Realizing that you have these rights, or you're not willing to answer questions or make a statement. So the second one. Okay. So I'll just read it again. Realizing that you have these rights, are you now willing to answer questions or make a statement?
Oh, I will make a statement.
Okay.
So you understand them.
Can I have the card so I could read it? I missed some. I'm sorry. I'm still having a little bit of problems. The third one?
All right, I'll read it.
We'll start all over.
Yeah.
We'll just read them all again.
So you have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to consult with a lawyer before questioning and to have a lawyer present with you during questioning. If you cannot afford to hire a lawyer, one will be appointed to represent you at public expense before or during any questioning, if you so wish. If you decide to answer questions now without a lawyer present, you have the right to stop the questioning and remain silent at any time you wish, and the right to ask for and have a lawyer at any time you wish, including during the questioning.
Okay.
So then the only two questions I asked were, do you understand?
Yeah, your rights? I understand, and I am willing to make a statement.
Okay, perfect. All right. So like we already said, I talked to you yesterday. So today is July 8th. It's about 5:11 now. We started talking at 5:08. So yesterday, July 7th, I came to your house where you live with your parents, Bart and Krista Halderson. And the reason I was there is you had gone to the Windsor Police Department and reported them missing, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I didn't go to the department. I went to the office break room mm-hmm. area.
In the same building?
I think it's mixed in with the city hall.
Okay. But nonetheless, a deputy came and spoke to you. Okay. So you reported your parents missing. We got some information from you yesterday. We've been following leads last night, working today to, go through different things, just trying to locate them, right? So I guess if you want to start with, let's just go back to last Wednesday.
Wednesday. I was with my dad. What time Wednesday? I remember it. It was kind of a bad day.
Okay. Why was it a bad day?
My mom had work, so she was gone. My dad and I were watching something over lunch. It was the Wheel of Fortune. And we normally have the couch, with our back facing her. The table we sat at the end of you coming.
Downstairs or upstairs?
Downstairs.
Okay.
In that room with the TV. I tossed the ball, and I smashed the glass.
Okay.
With the dog. The dog's help. That set my dad off. And we tried to clean it up.
Okay.
I don't know about him, but I got injured. But he was mad. He didn't really talk to me too much that day. My mom got home at 5, I believe. That's her normal, 5:20 to 5:30.
What time does she work,
7:30 is when she leaves. I don't know her hours, but I know when she leaves.
Okay.
7:30. And then all the way up till 5, and she comes home 5:20, 5:30.
Did she come home about 5:20, 5:30 that day?
I believe so, yeah.
Okay. So you guys are downstairs, just to touch back on that quick. So the couch, so yesterday when we were down in your basement, the couches were...
In a bed. He helped me put them in a bed before.
Okay.
And Thursday, but they put it into a bed so I could sleep near the bathroom, and the dogs sleep in that floor. So
okay,
they'll be a lot better if they're sleeping on that floor.
Downstairs floor?
Yeah.
Just cooler for them or something?
Probably.
Okay. All right, so you were tossing a ball. What type of ball was it?
It's this gross, hairy tennis ball that Rizzo loves.
All right, just like a green tennis ball, like a normal?
Yeah. Rumble.
Okay. With the squeaker, not like a tennis racquetball.
They don't chew those. My dog chews those out of any tennis ball. They just chew the squeakers out, and then they don't play with them anymore. All right, so you're just tossing that around, broke the fireplace glass. You said you were injured. What type of injury
did you have? I got a pretty deep hole in my foot. Last night, Mary looked at it, and she said the reason it keeps bleeding is because there's glass in it.
Oh, so that's the... You showed us your toe.
Yeah, I showed the detective lead.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so... That one. It could be infected, is what she's thinking, but Neosporin's been helping.
Okay, good. Keeping it clean and stuff. Best you can.
I know how, I guess.
Yeah. Okay.
Wednesday. Yeah. Once I got all the glass out of the dog's hair, she didn't sustain any injuries.
Good.
Nothing even on her nose. She got it with her shoulder bone, I believe. So glass dog. That was roughly around 2. And then the rest, he didn't really talk to me. I went back to doing like a job search, kind of just shitting my day away. Games, YouTube maybe. That's when I came across one of the jobs I liked. Then 5 o'clock rolled by and mom came home. Dinner.
What did you guys have Wednesday night?
I couldn't tell you.
Okay. Who made it?
I think it was probably just stuff in the fridge.
Okay.
I think we all did our own thing again.
Sure.
By the way, a detective at my house said something's happened, and while we were leaving, people were going inside. Is there a warrant for my house?
Should there be?
No, I'm just wondering if...
Okay.
As
far as I know, they were at your house and they were going to be there talking to you to ask if you would come up here and talk to us.
Yeah, but Officer Haley just like walked pretty much in to the gate, you know, the gate on the outside. Mm-hmm. She just kind of walked in. I was wondering.
Was that when you were getting your wallet?
No, we were out. I was in the car waiting to leave. I was just wondering if everything's okay, because she said something's happened.
Okay.
And we need to go down.
All right. I'll find out what that's about.
Oh, has anything bad happened?
Oh, not sure. Right. So Wednesday night, mom comes home. Dad was angry. Was he yelling, or what was? How would you describe dad being angry?
It was he would yell if you said something to him. I guess if you talk to him, if you give him his space, he'll be okay. So
Wednesday night.
Wednesday. If you just give him his space. That's all we did. Just give him his space. He won't yell or do anything.
Okay.
That's all we had to do. Just Ma and I went to clean, do some laundry, make our beds, stuff like that.
Who is we?
Ma and I.
Mom. Your mom. Okay. And that was Wednesday night.
Yeah, that was, we had an early night. No TV that night.
Gotcha. What time did your parents go to bed Wednesday night, do you think?
I was in bed at 8.
You were?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I couldn't tell you when they went to bed.
Okay. No worries. And you were downstairs, that's where you've been sleeping, you told me last night?
I was in my room Wednesday.
Upstairs, okay. Gotcha, so in the bedroom upstairs, and then you slept downstairs. Why have you been sleeping downstairs again? You told me last night. The bathroom's right there.
I need to be close, because stairs, I can't see too well in the dark now.
Yeah. Gotcha. And just like last night, I'm jotting some notes quick. You know, yeah. It doesn't mean one thing is more important than the other. It just means that I need to remember stuff. And sometimes,
I understand it.
Gotcha. All right, so did you sleep with your door closed that night or open?
Oh, yeah, I always have it closed.
Closed door, yeah, makes sense.
I have a feeling they argued a little bit after.
Parents did? What were they arguing about?
Probably what set my dad off that day, the glass.
Okay.
Us not having food ready, stuff like that. We just microwave whatever was in the fridge, I suppose.
Yeah. Who was upset about that?
Dad
was? Okay.
He usually doesn't like that. He likes the when we cook.
Okay. Does he ever cook?
I haven't seen him cook. Oh, he grills. He likes to grill. He grilled on Thursday.
Nice. All right.
I think I told one officer the green egg. He got... It makes terrible food, but yeah.
Dad does?
Yeah. Oh, the green egg.
Itself, oh, the green egg. That's like a grill or something?
Yeah, it's insulated and makes everything smoky.
Oh, okay.
It's Thursday morning. I wake up.
So what really happened on Thursday, July 1st?
Chandler's mum, Krista, goes to work in the morning.
And Chandler's father, Bart, works from home as an accountant.
Sometime in the morning, Chandler shot his father in the back 3 times in the basement of their home.
Yeah, a shell casing and a fresh divot from a bullet ricochet confirm that the basement is the killing zone. Chandler sends text to his mum asking her to pick up something from the shop for him. Just to delay her return, I think, while he cleans up the mess.
Krista returns home. Chandler kills her by unknown means, probably also shot.
Her and Bart's blood are later identified in the basement. That evening and throughout the night, Chandler burns his parents' body parts in the fire.
There was a strong, pungent smell. A neighbour noticed it. It was like some sort of meat cooking.
She's gone. My dad starts the grill around 8:39
in the morning.
To get the temperature right.
Was he working from home that day, or?
Yes.
Okay.
We ate the grill. Nothing really happened between that. We kind of either were outside with the dogs from the lighting of the grill. Him going in, taking a couple calls now and then, or emails or something.
Mm-hmm.
But we just kind of watched the grill and waited to get it set steady at hamburgers for $3.50-ish.
Okay.
We just kind of waited.
For the burgers?
And then we ate noon 30. Or 12:30, sorry.
Sure.
Then we went inside and had our TV show again, Wheel of Fortune. So it was on around our time for lunch. Or was it Family Feud? The Family Feud was Thursday. Family Feud.
Where'd you guys watch that at? Downstairs?
Same.
Okay.
A neighbor's security camera confirms that Chandler's fireplace had been burning all night.
Chandler uses an axe, garden saw, and scissors to dismember his parents. The tools are later found, and the blood of both parents is identified on all of them. Early that morning, Chandler buys a 6x8 tarp from Fleet Farm. And in the living room, where the fire is, Chandler has a measuring tape to make sure the body parts can fit in the fire.
To get the fire to burn hotter, he also used a small electric fan.
But he had a little problem. The hot fat from the severed body parts that Chandler was burning puddles out and breaks the glass on the fireplace. He's already blamed the dog for these, to cover his tracks.
I don't know, something went well for him. So that's all. Then we were hanging out again. My mom texts. I believe I texted her, everything's going well. His phone died, my dad. He didn't believe. He's kind of like charged it, put it on the dock, and left it. Then we just kind of hung out, and my mom gets home, and I start a shrimp scampi for my dad, because that's what he wanted, but we didn't have shrimp, so I made shrimpless scampi. That's where they told me while we were eating it, they were gonna go with their friends, and I was like, oh, cool.
And they said they were going to the cabin.
Yeah. Okay. We're going up north. That's how they recovered to it.
Who said that, mom or dad?
Ma. My dad doesn't talk while he eats.
Okay.
So there we are at Thursday dinner, up north of the cabin. My dad says, I'll need a set for pipe repair and gas. So I'm like, all right. I grab the pipe repair stuff from his plumbing chest, or plumbing box. It's like a tote of what you need for pipe repair.
Mm-hmm.
And two whatever jerry cans, I can't remember the amount, but they're red with the safety nozzles. Got those squared away. They had most of their duffels already packed at that point.
Mm-hmm.
And we all just started bringing them down to the mudroom with the shoes.
Yeah.
By the garage.
Where you showed me them.
After that, we watched is a Netflix original, Seven Underground, the thrill-seeking, they fake their deaths, and they fly airplanes, and they, fight at the evil of the world by being ghosts. It's pretty cool.
I don't think I've seen that one yet. Who was watching that?
The three of us.
All three of you? Okay.
All three. And that put it at 9. They had their drinks. Went to my computer. My computer was at that black table we sat at.
Sure.
We saw the stuff. Played a video game called Tarkov until midnight. Well, after midnight, maybe even. Kind of lose track of time. And my parents, by then, were asleep. They got their teeth brushed and everything. Then I got upstairs. That was Thursday. Yeah, so I did. So we got the bed all set before we played Tarkov. And that's when I crawled into bed from the black table. So after our movie, we set up my couch bed and the pillows for the girls.
Who helped you set the bed up?
My dad.
Dad, okay.
Because he knew he was leaving and I would need that. Friday morning, I woke up. They had left with the stuff was all set out. They remembered the gas. I found the folding chairs that they wanted to bring, but they never brought them. I'm assuming they couldn't fit them. So I put those away. That was Friday morning. I go upstairs do the dog or feed the dogs. It was around 6-ish, not 6:15 when I woke up. I was a little late that day.
6:15, Friday, okay.
That's just when I looked at my phone. Dogs saw my ma's note, the insurance for my appointment. I just ate whatever's on the counter. I think it was cornbread.
Where was the note from your mom?
That was on the kitchen, like there's a peninsula.
Yeah.
With the insurance stacked up. But I moved it to the table.
Okay. And then those insurance cards were there also with that we saw yesterday?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't think she knew which one I would need. But I have three now.
Mm-hmm.
Friday.
Yep.
So I hung out with Kat Friday night, I believe.
What'd you do Friday during the day?
Oh yeah. Let's work backwards. I kind of shoot the day away. I played video games.
Okay. Parents are gone. Why not, right?
Yeah. I didn't do anything that I should have. I should have been cleaning and all of that.
Seemed pretty clean when I was there.
You see all the dog hair? That's got to be gone.
It comes along with it, right?
Yeah.
All right, so Friday during the day, I just played video games, kind of.
Yeah, then after work, I believe that was the day Kat came over.
After whose work?
Kat, she is
after
five.
Her work.
Five is her work when she, okay. She was off. I believe she came over.
Done around 5.
Okay. The cat came at 5?
You said? I don't think she went straight here after. I believe she came over. It could have been later, like 6, maybe give her time for like getting clothes.
This was after work, did you say? Where she work at?
She works downtown Middleton. A farm tech.
Okay.
She, I believe she stayed with me on that couch that night.
So she spent the night over?
Yeah.
You guys both slept on the couch downstairs?
Yeah.
What'd you do before you went to bed?
It was Friday night. That might have been my own night. I might be wrong. I'm wrong.
Okay.
I think I spent that night alone. I just kind of gamed online with some of my friends. Oh, I said Saturday night. I'm so sorry, guys.
Yeah, no worries, man.
So one night, I gamed alone all night. One night, Kat spent the night on the couch. Oh, and Sunday, she spent the night in my bed with me. She helped me out.
Sunday night.
I know that because she didn't want to spend another night on the couch bed. She didn't like it. And she went to work on Monday morning. So that was the my bed night. Backtracking. One night she spent on the couch with me. Like the couch bed we've made. But one night I gamed all night, or all day and night pretty much, and I'm pretty sure that was Friday night, and let's go with Saturday was my night alone.
Okay. So Friday we believe she came over.
Yes.
And then Saturday was the game night.
Yes. So, backtracking to Friday, when she came by, we actually just, Bright. There's this movie, or a TV series on Netflix. We watched pretty much the entirety of that into the morning. It was, an apocalypse show.
Okay.
I don't know the name.
What time do you guys think you went to bed?
I say we stayed up well until 10, I would say.
P.M.?
Yeah.
Okay.
Gotta be at least. The morning. Saturday, we didn't do much.
So what really happens on Saturday, July 3rd? Kat gets a Snapchat from Chandler and notices he's in an unusual spot.
Chandler is out at his secret swimming hole on the Wisconsin River. When police investigate this location, they find severed portions of legs, which are identified as his mother's.
Saturday was like the peak, and it's kind of stayed out like this.
Okay. Peaked anxiety,
and this kind of like set me like fast for some space, and I just kind of gained Saturday. Couldn't tell you when I went to bed. I think I might have even stayed up till 2. Yeah, it's just the same game, Escape from Tarkov. I couldn't get a hold of any of my friends to play with, unfortunately. I played like some here and there from Discord, but none would like stick around for that late in the night.
Sure.
Then we get to Sunday. It's the 4th. In the morning, I'm a little worried about my family. I think I called my mom. Oh, throughout I've called, I don't know the times though. Throughout the weekend, I mean. But I called my mom, I believe, in the morning. There's along those lines, and I get a text from her. It was a text message, it wasn't even an iMessage, so I assume she said White Lake today. So she sent it that day. I couldn't figure out where she was because it was a text. There was no iMessage, so I kind of just like left it at that. They're safe, they're alive. Then it's the afternoon. I'm talking to Dan. I call him up and I ask him, well, what he's doing. Or maybe that was the morning, but I called Dan that Sunday. Asked him what he's up to, if he wanted to hang out. I don't like being alone at the house very long.
Dan is mom's coworker slash friend?
Yeah, he's
okay. This guy.
Go over there. He invited me for fireworks in his driveway.
He said, or you said yesterday, he lived in DeForest or Windsor, one or the other?
Yeah, close.
Okay.
I could point it at a map.
One or the other, I think it was.
So, okay. Throughout the day, the dogs, it's just me and the dogs, the fireworks, and the dogs are like running around and into things. I'm trying to keep them okay. All they're doing is knocking stuff over, spilled their water. They haven't eaten. They won't go outside for me. Even on a leash, I couldn't get them out.
What was the deal with that?
Fireworks.
Oh, the fireworks are spooking them so much.
Yeah,
all day. Gotcha. So
I put them both into the fort, crank the TV.
Did that seem to help at all with them?
Yeah. The loud TV helped. RZA doesn't like, or maybe does like, New Girl, the TV show, so we watched that. It's the theme song that gets her, I think. She barks. So we watched that. Izzy fell asleep, so Izzy's the old dog, the older one. Yep. So then it's Sunday. Right, Sunday evening, Kat comes by to help me with the girls.
So she wasn't there during the day?
No, it was just me and the dogs. She left Sunday morning.
Okay.
From the... No, she left Saturday morning because I spent Saturday by myself.
I see that.
And then Sunday, it was just me and the girls till whenever Kat got there. We didn't eat together, I don't think. No, this is Sunday. This is Sunday. So I went to Kat's house.
On Sunday?
So that was Sunday morning is when I left the girls. So all of Sunday morning, I had the girls in the fort. We watched New Girl. I went to Kat's house Sunday to eat, but we ended up not eating there. We went to Cress's house.
So here we are, Sunday, July 4th.
Chandler's story from this day is fairly legit. He did go out to Cress's property. He had a swim, but he also scoped out the place for what he planned to do the next day, Monday the 5th.
So Cress is...
You seen her on my phone?
Yeah, I saw the calls to her.
She
that's your,
helps me out with everything.
Kat's
mom's girlfriend.
Mom's girlfriend.
Okay. I try to talk to her as much because she's like, I don't know, wise, and she really helps me with what's going on with me.
Because
I've been in a slump, I'd say.
Okay.
But...
Alright, so went to Kat's house Sunday to eat. What time do you think you went over there?
Food at 3:30, that's what they said.
So about 3:30, you went over to Kat's?
Oh, I was at Kat's well before. I was at there noon.
Noon. Where does Kat live?
The east side.
East side of Madison?
Yeah.
Okay. You know I'm sure I could look it up, but do you know the road at all or anything?
Taffelger? Or Andrew Lane? Taffelger?
Okay. I'll look it up, that's fine. You went, met her Sunday about noon. What'd you guys do at her place?
Well, she realized my legs, I wouldn't be able to do stuff with them. So her brother and her brother's date went to a thrift store while she had me sleep. Just put me to bed and they went. And then they get home around 2:30. Kat and I rush back to my house, let the girls out, and we go back straight to the farm.
Okay, were you at the farm before you went to let the dogs out, or?
No, we were at Kat's, like a duplex.
So Kat's house, Sunday around noon, you went to sleep with Welsh Kat, her sister?
Her brother.
Kat's brother.
And his date.
And his date. Okay, sorry about that. Went to a thrift store.
Then we went to Cress's and we ate. After that, James left after dinner, leaving his date with us, and we took a swim. After the swim, we left, went to Kat's house to drop off his date. The date stayed at Kat's house. Is a Rose, maybe, is what her name was.
Rose. Had you ever met her before?
No, this was a Tinder match from her brother, Kat's brother.
Okay.
Um,
What time do you suppose you guys went to Cress's house? So, got to Cat's around noon, went to sleep.
We got back. Okay. Cat and I went to my house to let the dogs out, then we left. Oh, I think we got gas. And then we went to Cress's. So, I'd say we got to... It was maybe 4 when we got there. We were late for dinner. But it was good because they were still setting up.
Where'd you guys get gas at? Do you remember that?
One of the quick trips in town. I can't remember. I'm sorry.
When you say in town, are we talking DeForest, Sun Prairie?
DeForest, yeah, me.
Okay.
I think we got, I'm still not super sure, but I know we were doing something on the way, or we didn't do something. I thought we were going to do a return, but I'm jumbling it right now, mm-hmm. So just have that. We went to my house and back to Cress's. We were late.
Okay.
For dinner.
What were you guys driving? Were you in your
Cat's red Subaru?
Okay. Was she driving or you?
She okay. Drives that
Cat's
her car.
Red Subaru, you said?
Yeah. It's at my house right now.
Oh, okay. And you rode with her?
Yes.
Where'd you guys go for a swim?
There's like a little pool up at the Cress's house.
Oh,
she's been helping me with my walking and everything, and they get me there.
Okay. Is it indoor or outdoor?
Outdoor.
Cool. Must have been nice with how hot it was then.
Yeah, they got something fancy to heat it from the sun.
Okay.
But that was the 3 of us.
Yeah.
Then we went back to around 6, no, later, maybe 7. We went back to Kat's apartment, dropped off Rose, got Kat's wet clothes. She had wet clothes because she was going to dry them. And we went to my house together.
So Rose got dropped off at Kat's?
Yeah, the duplex in the east side.
Okay. Was James with you guys at that point, or?
No, James left after dinner around 4:30.
Okay. Was he not getting along with Rose, or?
No, he had work.
Oh, okay. That sucks. Working on the 4th of July.
Something.
So did Rose get dropped off at Kat's duplex then?
Yes. We'll refer to Kat's house as a duplex.
Yep.
Cress is the farm.
Yep.
We grow berries.
Yep.
My house is my house. That's how we're referred.
Gotcha.
Where are we?
Sunday night, about 7.
Sunday night, Rose about off 7. At Cat's. Rose dropped off. We get to my house. And we go to my house in DeForest, yep. Windsor. We feed the girls. We put her clothes that she brought, the wet stuff, in the dryer because that's what she needed to do. We get her clothes dry. That's after we get back, actually. And then we go to dance.
Okay.
For the fireworks. He asked us to come by 8:30. For some reason, I was trying to leave, but I was making a joke about it, that we're going to be late, like stuff like that, goofy crap.
Chandler's pretending he got burnt by the fireworks, but the damage to his hands was actually caused from burning his parents' body parts in the fireplace.
Gotcha.
Then we get there, we stay for 45 to an hour. That's how I got the bottle rocket marks.
Show me those.
The sparks.
That's right, you said and I think
this was a wad or something that flew back.
Shot back out of it.
Yeah, that one stuck in for a little bit. That's why it's so bad, but these are sparks.
Okay.
Those are a dance hall she got those?
Dance.
A dance.
I didn't know the stick. You don't hold the stick. The stick flies with it.
Oh, sure.
I didn't know.
So you're over at Dan's house, about 45 minutes to an hour.
Yeah, get my hands a little bit. We find a firework that it spins and takes off, and it went straight to the bush. So we were like, no more of that. We're done.
Did it light the bush on fire?
No, thankfully it wasn't hot enough for that.
Good.
After that, we cleaned. I gave him a bottle of wine as a thank you for letting us come. Thankfully, I still have a couple bottles at home. While we're there, Dan had a few beers. His girlfriend was there, or fiance, or wife. I'm not sure the relationship, but she was there.
And her name?
Never got her name. Just Dan's girlfriend. She's got purple hair. She's IT at MATC. Mm. Like the school's own IT.
Okay.
Anybody else there?
Just the two of us, and then the neighbors watched. One to our left and one across the street. One group. The one across the street had some cooler stuff than I've ever seen a person be able to own, firework-wise. But there we are. And then someone in the distance, kind of closer to our house, launched a mortar artillery firework. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, okay, we have to go home for the darks. So we went. And that was pushing 9:45. We got home. We got into the couch fort. And put on Daybreak was the apocalypse show. Daybreak.
It seems like there's fireworks everywhere in America at this time of year. The poor dogs have been missing their owners, distressed by the sound of fireworks, and distressed knowing that something is wrong.
The whole time, dogs are pushing me, nosing me, and everything. And so we kind of stop and stop watching, and she goes to bed. I'm trying to let the dogs out, or at least go back in a little bit. But the fireworks, they couldn't. Yeah. We get to bed upstairs in my room because she doesn't like the couch. And she had work in the morning.
Yeah.
And I'd say that's 10-ish, 10:30. And then the whole time, the younger dog keeps jumping on us. So I leave Kat in the bed, and I go sit out down in the couches and chairs down by the real dinner table. Mm-hmm. I go sit there and just hang out with the dogs so Kat can get asleep.
Where we first started talking last night?
Yes.
Like the main kitchen, door. Dining room, and the couches? Okay, gotcha.
I sit down there so Kat can get some sleep, because I don't work tomorrow. She does.
Mm-hmm.
Then I put the ladder in front of those steps so the girls can't come up. They pee on the kitchen, the tiles, so I clean that and at least they went before bed, you know. Mm-hmm. It wasn't the worst thing. They're not going to go outside.
Yeah.
Then I go to bed.
Okay.
Then it's Monday morning. Cat goes to work. 7:50-ish, maybe earlier. Then I'm left to myself. So we put on New Girl in the couch fort on Monday morning. Mm-hmm. I go back and forth through some video games, and then back video games. back, and then...
So what really happened on Monday, July 5th?
On Monday, Chandler goes out to Cress's property uninvited. This is where he stashes the torso of his father, Bart, behind a log and covers it with sticks and debris.
Yeah, he also stashes the saw and scissors that he used to chop his parents up with in a barrel on the farm, and the tarp he bought on Friday, which is also covered with the blood of his parents, and is discovered by police cadaver dogs a bit later on.
He must have also stashed the murder weapon there that day.
Yeah, the gun that was identified as the murder weapon was found in the barn at the property. Chandler was given the gun by a friend he met online, playing the video game Escape from Tarkov.
Thank goodness the online friend had the foresight to take a photo of the gun and ammo with Chandler's ID. That was the only proof of the gift he gave to Chandler.
Yeah, it was a Norinco SKS-76 by 46 caliber rifle.
This real gun was used in the video game they played together. Chandler was alone that night because he had a lot of cleaning to do.
And Crest together. And I think Kat's mom is all right with me. I don't know, she wants me to move into the east side Kat's house.
Okay.
And start paying rent as an apartment because she doesn't like to live at home.
Does Kat live with her mom or?
Kat has an apartment.
Okay.
Somewhere.
Kat does?
Yeah, it's by Mifflin.
Okay.
The Party Avenue, it's by there.
Okay.
So I'm there talking to their mom and Chris. Then I go up to have, a breakdown by their shed, and they go swimming. Right by the swimming pool is the shed, so they wanted to watch me, break down and all that. So after I noticed they're just watching, I just walk over to them.
Describe your breakdown to me.
I actually cried. Started kicking grass, just doing the toddler tantrum shit. Then I hopped in the water with them.
Okay.
It was too late. I was in the water and I realized Crest didn't have a top.
Okay.
And that was uncomfortable. But I talked to them more, and that's when she brought up the housing situation, how she doesn't like how my parents are. I guess I don't know. She doesn't know them that well. She's never met them.
Okay. Crest was saying that?
And Kat's mom. Kat's mom is speaks is her first thought right away.
Yeah.
So they're offering me to get a job, live with them, work for them while I'm working, and pay rent. And that's kind of their deal. I would have a month free of rent, or a month or two maybe, if they're thinking.
Mm-hmm.
I could be able to borrow a car from Crest, maybe if she's nice, they're not using it, I'd be able to go to work.
Does she have a lot of cars or something?
No.
No? Okay. Just an extra one, probably.
She stays at the farm.
Okay.
So if she didn't need it, I could use it.
Sure.
To go to a job, or at least interviews.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was hoping for a job, near where I live, so I could bike. That would keep me, these going. I don't think they can get worse, but I could keep doing it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
What was I doing? Where are we?
Sunday. So you were swimming, had a little breakdown. What were you having a breakdown about?
You ever have your legs
kind of... Yeah. No, I haven't.
It's just...
Okay.
I don't even know if they're done getting, as bad as they can be yet, so
yeah.
that's a
it's not fun.
And I think you were telling me last night it's a symptom of a concussion, right?
So is that right? That's not it. It's a symptom of nerve damage from the hit to my spine. So okay. It's permanent.
Okay. I understand that now better.
Yeah. So it's just legs. I think it's waist feeling is probably colostomy bag down the road and all of that. But here we are Sunday.
Yeah.
Okay, we're sitting in the pool, we're hanging out. They're just talking to me. Sometimes they're being nice, sometimes they're like making the offer, like, hey, if you move in, you can pay rent. This is a good neighborhood. It's a cul-de-sac, there's parking. So, yeah, on the east side, just off of Milwaukee Street, that's Andrew. Oh, okay. You take a left turn onto Andrew, down Milwaukee.
Yep.
So, that's it. So, it's a good neighborhood, kind of like the one by my parents.
Mm-hmm.
If I live there, I at least be on doing my own thing. And then they're like, well, appreciate you stopping by, so I head out, and I go, that was Monday afternoon, I go to dinner at Kat's house on the east side.
Okay. What time do you think that was?
It had to be 7:30, I left the farm, which is Cress's.
7:30 p.m.
Cress's is the farm.
Okay.
So, we're at Kat's. And then she's planning on feeding me. This is Monday, correct?
Yeah.
That's after the farm, so I'm in Cress. I think we just eat and cuddle a little bit.
Okay.
I go home. There's the girls. Let them out and go to bed because I kind of had a day.
Yeah. What time do you think you left her place?
I'd say 9.
Hit and left about 9, okay. She didn't come with you?
No, I was alone that night.
Okay.
I really want to drag her away.
Sure.
I think she stayed at her apartment, her house that night, not apartment.
Okay.
So, there we are. Tuesday morning.
So now we're up to Tuesday, July 6th, which is another cleaning day for Chandler.
The stress of being under interrogation after so much strenuous activity, killing and dismembering two people, would take so much effort, let alone trying to keep his story straight.
Or now wakes me up. I did the 6 again with the dogs and the food, but I got back in bed. I don't know if I passed out or zoned out a little bit, but Dan is worried about my ma on Tuesday, I think.
Did he call or text?
I said no word. My ma, I don't know if he called or texted.
Okay.
I think he just contacted. That's what I can think of.
Reached out. Yeah.
Yeah, he reached out. Then I'm like, oh, it's Tuesday morning. They should be here. No worried. I think I called my mom that day.
All right.
And then
you talked to her?
No, she never picked up.
It's always either.
It's always the voicemail. It's a voicemail. You know when so it's off, out of range. I don't know the other factors that could give you that.
It's like a voicemail right away. Goes right to voicemail, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So whatever factors can give you that.
So I might have missed it. So from the time like they left, did you talk to them at all when they were
I got a up text. North?
You got the one text.
And I
that you mentioned earlier.
Don't even like it.
Right?
Yeah.
But that was it? Nothing else?
Yeah. So that's fishy to me, even the text, because I realized Memorial Day is when the White Lake Parade is.
Oh, sure.
There's no 4th of July. Maybe there's cheap drinks, but there's no parade at White Lake on the 4th. So, well, maybe there is now. I realize I've always gone on Memorial because that's the weekend. I get time off from school and all of that. You don't get time off for the 4th.
So basically, from the time that they're gone at the cabin in your home, you know, running around doing what you're doing, you just had one communication with mom.
Yeah, that's kind of how I just assumed the amount of people, where they're at, and whether sure. all.
Well, I understand. I'm just making sure it wasn't more than one.
Her not contacting, but this was the only text.
Was there anything with dad?
No, I don't even bother talking to him. He wouldn't use his phone while he's up there. He loves it.
Oh.
Do that, but, you know.
Does he keep his phone on him when he's up there?
It's usually in the car.
Oh, okay.
My brother and I just text all the time while we're up there. We even set up wire antennas sometimes to make better connection.
Sure.
Okay. So here we are.
Where? Tuesday. Called mom. Voicemail immediately.
Voicemail immediately Tuesday.
Where? Dan called, worried about mom not coming to work. You had already fed the dogs and that before Dan called in or reached out to.
Trip one day. Well, I think that could have been Tuesday morning.
Okay.
A quick trip. I got a coffee, and I used my dad's number at a quick trip to get me the free one because it was the Cruise of Gold. Yep. I could have afforded it, but you know, there's a free one. And it's Tuesday, or it wasn't Monday. I could have gotten a dollar one, but it was full price, I believe, and I grabbed that. The coffee, because it was a free one. He hasn't used it for weeks, so I grabbed that. Had a quick trip. I couldn't tell you which one. I was just driving at that point.
When you use his rewards card, is what they call it, right?
Yeah.
You just enter his phone number or something.
You type it.
Okay.
But I got a coffee. Had to be, I'm assuming, Tuesday. And I got a free one.
Sweet.
It was terrible.
Oh, it was?
I wanted to try Karuba Gold.
Yeah.
It wasn't bad. Then we're at Tuesday. Cat's working up, and I'm gaming, job hunt. And then I started trying to get the glass. Because I've been a little lazy on the glass. I just kind of had chairs in front of it. I just had a broom and, you know, a little sweeper holder. You know, you broom it into that.
Dustpan.
Yeah. And I'm tossing the glass into recycling. I get most of it. There's a bunch in the cracks of the stone that I'm picking out by hand. I didn't injure myself from that, but just yeah.
Okay.
Just my blood was kind of on the floor, so I got the Swiffer I borrowed from Kat from the foot. I borrowed a Swiffer to mop. I Swiffered the floor, like not the stone, but the floor. And then I got a little bit in the kitchen. And then everywhere kind of I walked, pretty much. The bathroom, the kitchen, and then I couldn't get the carpet, so I still stained that up a little crappy.
Where was their carpet at?
The stairs between basement and kitchen.
Carpet. Oh, that's right.
Carpet stairs. I tried. I can't get it out. I don't know how to do that, but then all the way up to my the laundry room where I found my first aid kit. I just tried to stop all the bleeding, but it wouldn't stop. So.
And that blood was all coming from your left foot.
Yeah, left foot hole.
Left foot hole.
Yeah.
I mean, are we talking massive amounts of blood? Or are we talking, a little bit, like, describe?
It started as drops until I got to the bathroom. And then I got back to go grab my sock and some of the paper towel. And then I see the glasses in there, so I grab a tweezer and I pull it out. And then it starts squirting out. I got some on a little bit of the rock. It wasn't that bad of the rock, but it, I think the worst was that floor. That, like, it kind of, like, like this lid puddles.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't good.
Are we talking the floor down in the basement?
Well, that one, and then I go upstairs to the kitchen, and it's still going, and I'm trying to get my foot in the sink just to slow it down and pinch it, maybe. And then I waddle upstairs to the IFAC, or the first aid kit. And once I got it kind of bundled up, it stopped for what I know. Then I go, I need to get some tape. We have a tape box in the basement. I go there and I opened it up again. And I bled a little bit more, but the basement was easy to clean. It's just cement,
mm-hmm.
a little bit of water, and I ragged that up. But I grabbed the tape box and I wrapped it. After that's Tuesday.
Yep.
That's Tuesday. Wings. I go to Cats.
Oh, okay.
We had wings.
What time?
I've been doing the BS of first aid and all that. I go to Cat's house with her mom and her brother. That could have been 5 or 6. I can't give you the exact.
Did you guys pick up the wings and go there, or?
No, I drove to Cat's.
Okay.
Straight there.
What'd you drive?
The Subaru.
Sorry. Car of choice.
I just, with the Volvo seat, it, like, just, I can't do it with my foot.
Okay. So we're talking about wings. Did you guys go pick up wings? Or?
Yeah, so we get there, and we're calling around, seeing what's up. James is getting home with Jimmy John's. And we're like, oh, don't eat all of it. He's like, oh, I'm hungry now. Do all that post-gym crap. So he grabs, eats half of his sandwich, and then we go, Kat and I, the two of us in my car, we go to Buffalo Wild Wings.
Do you remember which one?
I couldn't tell you.
Okay.
I don't. Had to be east, right? That's close to
yeah.
It's by a mall.
Probably east on them,
it's by a mall. There's a mall. We go in, we get the wings, we go out. We go to Cat's, we eat. We watch this movie, Pretty in Pink or something. It's about a girl that likes fashion and goes to Harvard. So,
is that on Netflix or is it normal TV?
They have, like, everything there. I didn't know.
All right, so you eat the wings at Cat's, watch Pretty in Pink.
Yeah, it was a mom's choice. But, all the four of us, we all ate.
Okay.
And then went upstairs, laid down in her bed for a few minutes.
Just letting the food settle, or
yeah,
hanging out.
Notice she's kind of fallen asleep. So I'm like, okay, I'm ready to get out of here. And I go home, get the girls all ready for bed, going outside, get them water.
What time do you think you made it home?
Say 9. At the latest. Some girls, water, not really food, they ate before, but water, and play, like, indoor playtime in the bathroom.
Sure.
So.
Did you guys go to, so you were home alone then?
I've been home alone this whole weekend, really, except when Kat comes.
Yeah.
So Kat didn't come that night. So now we're pushing Wednesday, aren't we?
What time do you think you went to bed on Tuesday night?
Probably pretty dang close to when I got home, 10 at the latest.
Okay.
Kind of been tired lately.
Sure.
Then in the morning on Sunday? Or no, wait, where are we?
Wednesday already.
Wednesday, okay, so Wednesday. I try to go to the farm, and I keep spamming Cress. I kind of needed someone to talk to because freaking out about my parents. Jane's calling me. I give her the address to go to the farm, or to the cabin. Jane Helgendorf. Never picked up from Cress, so I go home.
Did you drive over to the farm, or?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because she wasn't answering her phone, right?
No, I got close, but then I realized I can't just show up. They'd shoot me. They don't know what I drive, or what I look like with a hat on.
They got guns over there, or would they actually shoot you?
No, I'm just saying. Her dad lives there. He's 90. He got a buck when he was 95 or something. So I know if he didn't know who I was, he could have.
Yeah.
So he's old. But he can use a gun. That's why I wouldn't do that.
Yeah. So Cress's dad lives there too.
Yeah.
Is it Cress's farm or dad's
it's
farm?
It's her dad's. He built it.
Oh, okay. And then she
lives there. She's okay. Managing the property because he's in a chair.
Yeah, he's old.
An old man in a wheelchair who's trigger happy? Oh, wow. I wouldn't want to go there either.
He's really losing his story now. He can't keep up with what he did on what day.
The beast, that's pretty much it. And their own berries. But it's, then here we are. I turn around and then Jane calls. I get a picture of the property at the cabin. And I see that. So I'm looking at the cabin. And it doesn't look right. There's a birch tree in front. And I didn't like the look of it because that didn't just sit right with me a little bit. But it looked like tracks were pushed down into the grass a little bit. I don't know, from the picture. And Mike said there was like light tracks, like someone was there.
Where was the birch tree at?
It looked like it was in the middle of the drive. And sometimes we do that. We find a fallen log and we put it like a double door entrance.
Mm-hmm.
So you go in from the gate, you park, you move the next, and then you drive.
Yeah, sure.
So that's like the only security we can get up there. We have done that before. The grass is overgrown, but that's from the storm and the fallen trees.
Mm-hmm.
You can't mow there because the flowers.
So with the birch tree, I mean, if you guys typically put stuff down like security, why did it look weird to you this time?
I've never seen that log. We have this log that's close to the shed. It's I would say closer to petrified than rotten. It's hard, like really hard.
Yeah.
I don't know what kind of tree, but that's what my dad and I use when we go.
So you typically use the same tree. This one just seemed out of place, too.
Yeah, that's not the tree we use.
Gotcha. Wednesday morning.
Wednesday the 7th of July.
Up the cabin, you see the birch tree and look right to you.
Then I go to the police station because I ask her, when should I make a thing? Point period. I'm sorry.
No worries, man.
What?
Wednesday morning, you said you went to the police department.
Yeah, to make a... Talk to him about my parents, and then I met with three sheriffs that came.
Three, you said?
Three. There was a Seely. He's bearded. The guy that drove me here, I'm not sure the name. And then Collins. She was also doing canvassing.
Mm-hmm.
So canvassing. So here we are, those three. I get the questions answered. Then... Oh, then we go to my house. And then there's three more, the same three sheriffs.
So they talk to you at the police station or wherever you
get... Yeah, I get information and stuff like that.
And then they came to your house.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's probably about, then I came a couple hours later.
They were there questioning, you're here now questioning.
Mm-hmm.
And then that night, Wednesday night, I go to Dan and Mary's.
Wednesday night. What time do you think?
They feed me, I had probably 7:30.
And you said you went to?
Dan and Mary Sesto, or Mary Sesto and Dan. Something a bitch. So
Mary Sesto's house.
Mary Sesto's house. It's on the same road
as yours. Much.
Yeah.
Okay.
They just up
the curves. Around the corner. For dinner, you went there?
Yeah. Well, they just fed me. They didn't eat.
Okay.
They just wanted to brainstorm.
Any good ideas come out of it?
No.
Okay. So you said
only could think of Dan, and Dan's been here.
Yeah. So you said you went to the police department to talk about your parents. Just tell me, what exactly did you talk about your parents with the deputies about?
Oh, we're making a report.
Okay.
A report that I thought I had to do that at a station.
Okay. And you were reporting, like, what were you reporting exactly? I just want to write down and have it on there.
They're missing this.
Okay. They're missing this. Okay. Gotcha.
And
as far as you know, were you able to tell? We've gone into a lot of detail last night and tonight, right?
Yeah.
Do you think that you gave them as much information as you've given me, or do you think that we've
kind of gone into more? You asked way more questions.
Yeah.
So you even asked about my injuries, the bleeding in the fireplace.
Yeah.
The sheriffs kind of gave what they need to make reports, and you've just asked about, like, home life.
Everything, right? Okay.
So you got more in depth.
Yeah,
I think. Wednesday, here we are, and throughout the weekend I've been calling.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Just kind of look at some things here. So we started Wednesday. Mom had work. You and your dad watched Wheel of Fortune. I'm just going to kind of read stuff back through a little bit, okay? And we kind of ended it last night because I've been talking to you since then, you know, so I don't think there's much else that I need you to tell me from last night. So watching Wheel of Fortune, you're on the couch, table downstairs, couch with the back to the table downstairs, and tossing the ball around for the dog and broke the glass fireplace. Your foot gets hurt, dad gets mad. dog was fine, not injured at all. Was it the dog or the ball that crashed into the glass?
Both. The ball bounced it, but the dog hit it with the shoulder. Okay. That's how it broke. The ball wouldn't have done it.
The dogs didn't break that glass on the fireplace.
All right. Playing games, watching YouTube, job search. I'm just going to, instead of reading out loud, just make sure I don't have any questions. You guys typically make your beds every day? Look like they were made yesterday when I was there.
Yes.
Okay.
We usually use sheets every few days in beds.
Change the sheets every day?
Every few.
Yeah.
They get changed.
I was going to say, that's
motivated. In the cases. The dog hair, it's kind of hard to sleep.
Yeah, they probably do have some pretty long hair.
The heat they shed.
Yeah, I know. That's fine. I get it. I got a dog. He sheds too, but you got two of them. You know? All right. As far as the blood on your foot, how did you clean that up? So we were talking, you had blood on...
Swiffer wet jet.
Okay, Swiffer wet jet. And where did you get that from?
Can't let me borrow it.
Where is it at now?
And now he's trying to blame the blood all over the house as all coming from his foothole. Check out that tiny cut on his toe. As if that could make puddles all over the house.
We just brought it back. Gave it back to her.
Did you use anything else?
Hydrogen peroxide for the tiles and the hard floors. Just the big globs needed a little bit.
Hydrogen peroxide. Did that seem to help get rid of the blood?
Well, it hurt my foot and stuff. But it didn't really help. Okay. It kind of just made a mess.
And when you say only on tiles, I'm trying to remember your house.
I couldn't do carpet with it. Yeah. It would ruin the carpet, right?
It would. I think so. Tiles, are we talking kitchen? Because downstairs is just like cement.
Well, when I had some blood on the basement, I used the peroxide.
Okay. Basement floor and tiles in the kitchen?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, peroxide. There wasn't as much. There weren't, this size pools in the kitchen.
Okay.
I was pinching it pretty dang hard, but which was also cutting deeper because I had another, or might still have another piece of glass.
Is that the biggest pool that you saw was something?
This was downstairs. Okay. This was kind of on the stone, close to the glass, and then there was one right at the base, kind of where the chairs I put.
Okay.
Like a good 2 or 3 inch diameter.
Two or three inch diameter. Okay.
More than that.
Did you do anything to... So I wrote down on Tuesday that you tried getting the glass cleaned up in the basement, tossed it in the glass glass and recycling. Did you clean up at all when it actually happened?
No. My dad was furious.
So you just...
He did stuff.
To clean it?
Yeah. I don't know what he did. But he sent me to my room upstairs, and he did whatever he did, but it still was on the floor after he was done.
Okay. Did your dad get injured at all when the glass broke? Did he step on any of it?
He sent me up, but I don't doubt it. When he gets mad, he's not thinking.
So, but we don't know if your dad got hurt?
No.
Okay.
No. My best guess is that guy reached in the fireplace and cut off his arm or something. I don't know.
What's up?
Head pain? Do you guys have Tylenol or something? I know you guys can't really offer anything like that. But
a headache?
Yeah, I've been getting the migraines from all of the hits and stuff.
Yeah, we can try to get you something.
Mm-hmm. So, all right, so cleaning up the blood, we just got the Swiffer and the hydrogen peroxide.
Yeah, just kind of smeared it around. There's another paper toweling. Yeah, just that.
Okay.
And then there's, I don't know.
Where did all those paper towels go? Just in the trash?
Yeah. Some. Just everywhere in my car trash, in my trash.
They ended up in the car trash?
There's a bag in the car that I carry around. It's a car trash.
Oh, okay.
It's like a gallon bag.
Okay.
That's more portable than the garbage can. So, yeah, bloody rag after bloody rag, just trying to get it all up.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It was a lot. I didn't feel sick, so it couldn't have been that much, right?
Yeah, you didn't lose enough to pass out or anything. Is there any reason to believe mom or dad's blood would be somewhere in the house? Have they been injured at all that you're aware of?
Well, my dad scratches his psoriasis till he, like, gushes blood.
Okay. Gushing. Describe gushing to me.
Enough to run down your leg. Like cover your leg, I suppose. Like, he has it on his knee. So he does this. It just, like, drips down. I ask him to stop, but he doesn't do it when he's stressed out.
Yeah.
He just kind of like, it's his tick.
Probably itches. Does he, does it enough to get on the floor? Does it leave?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like how much, like, before we're talking the water bottle lid and the Yeti lid, is there, I mean, like, are we talking puddles like that or just ribbons or?
It could be enough.
Okay.
But I'm thinking Yeti lid if he's there and I don't catch him soon enough.
Oh, jeez.
My mom's blood, just from her bloody noses she gets sometimes when she wakes up. That's why we've been doing the humidifier and dehumidifiers.
Yeah. Probably downstairs you get the...
We have to do multiple of them, but she can't be in the living room too long because that's a dehumidifier. Yep. And if she does, her nose gets bad. Not like a regular one, she gets it bad. But she either goes to the kitchen to fix it, her vanity, or the bathroom.
When she has bloody noses, are we talking, it's just spraying around? Is it just dripping?
Well, it's not squirting, but it's just dripping, and she doesn't notice it.
Okay.
Because she can't feel it anymore.
Okay. Is there any reason to believe that in either one of their vehicles there would be any of their blood?
Their vehicles?
Yeah. Or anybody's vehicle, let's say that.
Maybe car trash. Mom's car trash would definitely, the past few days. My dad's car trash.
Why would they have blood in their car trashes?
Well, my mom does the bloody noses with the air conditioning, so
okay.
In the, when we have air conditioning, my mom will have to use, bring towels and stuff,
yeah.
Because in the hot days, you can't have your windows open, you won't drive well.
No.
So air conditioning, my mom will have nosebleeds. My dad hasn't had them as much as she does, but he gets them.
Okay.
His are worse than my mom's.
Does he ever get them in the house then, or?
Mostly just with the air conditioning.
Okay.
And sometimes with the dehumidifier.
Okay.
Me personally, just in air conditioning.
Mm-hmm.
I get them, but not as bad as my parents. It's not bad.
Okay. All right.
Thank you.
Halderson right now.
I'm just thinking.
He's kind of absorbing.
I just want to make sure that I'm asking everything so I don't have to keep calling you and stuff.
Oh, and you know my brother? Is he okay?
Mitch?
Yeah, did he make it? I know, that's a long drive for
he hasn't those called, two. Yeah, he hasn't called me at all, so I don't know.
I don't think they've ever done a trip like that. So yeah,
it's like 3 hours, 3.5
Yeah. Like, no. Mitch, okay, what happened?
Okay. As far as up at the cabin, when do you think the last time you were up there?
Personally, last year.
Last year.
Memorial Day, I believe. If it wasn't the weekend before Memorial. I didn't make the parade. I never got through it last year.
When do you think the last time your mom or dad were at the cabin before?
My dad went when my brother was diagnosed with diabetes.
When was that?
The weekend before my concussion, so 1, 2, 3. Well, not including this week, 3, 4. Yeah, 4. 4 weeks.
Is your brother
up?
Brother doing okay. He wasn't born with diabetes then.
No, this was. Okay. Like it's the kind you're born
talking about
with.
June of this year, like 3, 4 weeks ago?
Yeah.
Okay.
He went up, noticed our plumbing's gone to crap, and he bought a new set or something at a flea farm or a Home Depot, or it's like a four-way converter type thing for the plumbing.
Okay.
Something.
For the cabin?
Yeah, for the cabin.
Is it for like a toilet or?
Yeah, we have a toilet up there actually now.
Nice. Not just an outhouse?
No, there is an outhouse.
Yeah, you want an aspirin?
I appreciate that. Advil. Cool. What did you say?
I got Advil. Does that work?
Yeah. Cool. I thought you said Adderall.
No, I don't know.
Not that. This is Advil. This over the counter stuff.
Yep.
Thank you.
Like 3 of them work?
Yeah. There you go. Appreciate it.
You bet.
I'll drop them on there. Thanks, Tim.
Yep. Say Advil on them, right? Did you put them on your mouth already?
Oh,
there they are.
Nope, I just got.
So the plumbing went
true
crap.
Serum.
No.
Was it a sink or a toilet or what was it with the plumbing that went bad?
So when we have to pour water in every time we go up to start the pump.
Oh, okay.
So some reason by pouring water in, the water never rose in the toilet bowl apparently, so you couldn't flush it. You know, the water didn't come to the toilet.
Mm-hmm.
So he needed a new thing to stop whatever the problem was. I think leaking. I don't know. I didn't hear everything from him.
Sure. How did he find out about that?
He?
Yeah. How did he know that there was a plumbing issue up there?
Well, he went up there just to go see the cabin.
Oh, so when he went up a couple weeks ago, he realized an issue. This time, he wanted to fix it.
Yeah, well, he fixed the major issue, so it won't be flooding the house.
Okay.
The cabin. Now, he wanted the pipe set to redo it.
Okay.
Because we need new pipes because they're lead. And I think we might be moving to plastic. Because there's no water heat, we can do plastic.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Okay, I'm trying to figure out what that part was. But that was when Mitch, diabetes, the number one.
Did Mitch go up there with him?
No. Well, my mom and I were kind of with Mitch all that weekend doing stuff.
Dad just went alone.
Yep. And then later that week, I had my fall. And I just started getting my memory back.
Okay.
So.
Where did his mom been up there this year at all?
Mom has not been up there this year. Okay. Maybe they were up there before. No. I think Dad did it all himself, maybe.
Okay.
I think this is first.
And Mitch hasn't been to the cabin in a while, right?
Today?
Well, other than today.
Yeah, I couldn't say he's been there. He didn't go last year.
Okay. Does he kind of do his own thing, or?
Mitch hasn't lived with us, or, you know. he's got a family now, a dog, a girlfriend, no kids, but
cool.
It's kind of, you know, I've just had time. You know how it is with brothers.
Yeah, okay.
He just flew the coop.
Got a few of them myself.
Yeah.
All right.
I've started thinking about that myself, and my parents are trying to figure that out with me.
Mm-hmm.
We got all the background, I think, right?
Yeah, I think so.
So, I think it's time we start talking about what happened to your parents. Okay. Like, the truthful version.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, we have, like, 20 pages of writing. We're going to start with a clean, white piece of paper for you to start telling the truth.
Okay.
What? Because, listen to me. This is the only chance you're going to have to tell us the truth.
Okay.
What we, listen. I can't tell you what we know, but we know you're not telling us the truth. We know your parents are no longer with us. Okay, and we know the reason why. Okay, you need to tell the truth.
Listen.
You need to tell the truth about what happened, and just tell us why it happened. Okay, if something happened, if you were defending yourself, or if you just got fed up with stuff, you need to tell us the truth. Okay? This is your chance to tell us why. Okay? I'm not BSing you. Okay? So can we do that?
Okay. You're okay. What happened? Okay.
You know what happened. We're not going to tell you what happened. You know what happened. You were there when it happened. We're not BSing you, okay?
I wasn't there when it happened. Can I?
You know more than you think we know.
I understand. But
there's people that have told us things. We have evidence. We have proof that more has happened, okay? So your parents never made it to the cabin, and I think you know that.
You want to stand up and just come right over here for me? Do you have anything in your pockets at all?
Wallet.
Just a wallet that you just put in there for me?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Faith in the coin purse.
What's this right here?
Faith in the coin purse.
Yeah. So they won't take the vape down in the jail?
Okay.
We just wanted to give you a bit of a personal thank you for watching.
And to everyone who's been supporting this channel, we really appreciate you. You can find Chandler's condensed trial on our Courtney Act documentary channels. The link is here. And please check out our new channel, Crimes of the Times, which tells stories of true crimes and their consequences.